Hello, Siri.
Hi, iPod King Carter.
Siri, who are we going up against in the NBA Finals?
Here's Portland.
Siri, are they really any competition for Dom City?
I suppose not.
Thank you.
Your wish is my command.
Basketball's biggest day, the NBA Finals. It begins here, and 2K Sports is happy to bring it to you. Hi, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan. With me, Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. Now, before Game 1 of the NBA Finals gets going, let's give you the State Farm starting lineup. First for the 76ers. They've got Trevor Booker. He had 19 points in the win against Chicago. Then it's Paul George, and it's Yurepko in at the four. And then for the Portland Trailblazers, Felton is out there with Brandon Roy. And the man in the middle at the center, the big guy, Greg Oden. He's a big part of that presence down low. Then it's Waltz, and it's Aldridge in at the power forward. They're the top seed, possessing home court advantage, and they're looking to come out and make a statement here in this first game.
And that's really imperative.
Yeah, what's going on, everybody? iPod King Carter here, the Superman of YouTube. Did anybody catch that right there? Brandon Roy is still on the Portland Trail Blazers. I made this my player before the NBA officially started. So for all you people that are great Brandon Roy fans, you guys get to see him play in this entire series. I don't know what to say, man. I'm real psyched about this because I really haven't kept up with anybody in the NBA on my player mode since I started it. But it's spectacular to actually see Brandon Roy. Like, check him out going for the layup with the nice Euro step. But it's crazy, man. Like, I'm real hype right now. But I'm not as hype as Paul George is on the alley-oop. It's the finals, y'all. This is what it's all about. This is for the NBA championship, man. This series is going to be crazy. Also, who would have ever thought that Portland would have made it to the finals in the NBA? I guess Brandon Roy really is something. Check him out on a nice fadeaway. He couldn't get it, but you see me out on a break. I'm going in for the Tomahawk Slam. Now, a lot of people have been asking me, hey, iPod, what's your package? What's your dribbling moves? What's your shot? Guys, ladies, go inside the description. All of my info is inside the description about my layup package, my dunk package, my dribble moves, my shot. Everything is inside the description. I tell you guys every video, if you check out the description, I guarantee that you'll be happy with what you see. A lot of your questions will be answered. And also, in the comment section, please hit me up, man, because I'm going in for this alley-oop. I missed it, but check out this foul right here that happened to, Felton? Yeah, Felton got his second foul, so he's out the game right now. This is what happens, man. A lot of people have been telling me, oh, you just been fouling out the point guards going in the post. Nah, to tell you the truth, the point guards are always fouling, man. It's like they're so overzealous, you know, they're thinking that I'm going to go in all the time. But really, it's my team that I'm trying to pass the ball to. Now, check out this play right here. They got the rebound. Now, check out Brandon Roy. Cash. That's why Brandon Roy is in this game. He's really probably the reason why they made it to the finals, man. Real talk. But check out my boy Booker going in. You see him call for the ball. I'm telling you, every time somebody calls for the ball, I'm giving it to him, man. But here goes a nice little play. Yee is back. If you guys didn't notice, Yee is getting limited minutes, but he can still rise with the nice back spasms. It's all good. Now, you see what's coming down the court on this play right here. I'm getting my assist game, but I'm trying to, you know, pass it to people. Now, check out Booker. Booker is not playing this game. That's two contact dunks in a row coming down whenever he touched the ball. I'm liking this so far. You know, so far he's showing me something, especially on Brackens. Now, check out this play right here. Brackens, on a previous play, he shot a three-pointer and made it. But on that play, he shot it and missed. So, it's crazy. But my shot is cash. You know, it's all good. Sometimes, you know, 2K, it's just unrealistic how some players make unbelievable shots. And then, you know, let's not worry about that alley-oop. We'll worry about that later. But, you know, they make all of these shots. And then, you know, when it's something uncontested and close, they miss. I don't understand. It's like everybody could shoot threes. But when it comes to the mid-range game, nobody can make a shot. Even the computer, it sometimes, you know, it kills me, but we're running my patented play right now, PHI Alley. We're trying to see if this can run to perfection. Now, as you can see right there, I could have had a three-point shot, but It didn't work that way, so I passed it to my boy George, and he gets this shot. It's all good. My assist game is crazy right now, man. We are only in the second quarter, and I got 13 assists already. Trust me, you guys, I'm not trying to break any record. I promise you, if I was trying to break a record right now, I'd probably have about 25 assists. Seriously, because I know a lot of you people want me to break the assist record. But, you know, sometimes I like to score, man. I don't know what it is. When the ball is in my hand, it seems like I got to do something with it, man. I don't know. But check out that play right there. Brandon Roy, he can't make anything to save his life. This guy, he's wasting away right now. But check out the Euro step right there. That's the first time I actually completed a Euro step with the continuation and the foul. Even though I didn't get the shot, it seems like every time I Euro step, I get bumped and there's no call. So I guess I'm getting my layup up. I don't know if it's due to that or what, because my shot in traffic has been on 99 since probably about, I would say, 4 or 5 games before we went into the playoffs. That's all I'm saying. But this right here, we're down 2. The computer, I don't know, man. It takes him forever to give me the ball. But after I hit this shot right here, we're going to go into halftime, guys.
Hello, I'm Damon Bruce, and welcome to our coverage of the NBA Finals. Game 1 here on HP at the Half. Trailblazers in a close one against the Philadelphia 76ers. It could go either way, both teams trying to take the first game of this NBA Finals. Well, LaMarcus Aldridge is making it look easy against the 76ers. Seems like everything's falling for him. Not sure if he even knows how to miss. And for the 76ers, also a strong start. You can talk about lights out shooting, but this is out of this world. They simply can't miss out there. Some great work out there by Paul George. He's got 8 points and also been chipping in on the glass, hauling in a few rebounds. And now, here's some of the stats from tonight's 2 top performers. That's it for us now. Thank you very much for joining me. Hope you enjoy the second half.
Oh, man. After the first half, that was probably the first time that I've scored under 20 points without getting fouled out of a game. It's crazy. But check out Paul George going for the alley-oop. It's Dime City for a reason, man. We take this on the road. We do it in practice. We love throwing alley-oops, man. That's my favorite part about being a point guard, just throwing the alley-oops up, man. Now, check out Aldridge on this play right here. He kicks it out to Felton. Felton, I don't know what happened to him. I'm not even going to complain because it was my steal. Look, I'm not even going to lie. I don't know what happened. Maybe it's probably him trying to throw the ball out and then I just bumped him. I don't know, but I'm grateful for it. Now, check out Roy, man. Yo, this is just crazy to see Brandon Roy playing on my player. It's a lot of people that say, oh, man, I wish I could play with Brandon Roy. I wish he was on my team. This right here is psyching me out. But check out Felton, man. After we called the double team, he hits the shot. It's tied up right now. Now, after this little tie, you see Felton. He could have shot that. I don't know why he didn't. Probably because he wanted Brandon Roy to do stuff like that. Miss after miss after miss. I don't know what's up with Brandon Roy this game, but it's all good. Now, you see the continuation once again. I don't know, man. Maybe my layup is just that good. I haven't done Euro steps in a while. Seriously, like, I don't know what it is this game. Maybe, you know, they're too slow. I don't know. But I'm loving getting them off. Now, I've noticed one thing about Portland. This is probably going to be an easy series just because the ball runs through Brandon Roy. And the only thing about it is when the ball runs through Brandon Roy, the only person that Brandon Roy passes it to is LaMarcus Aldridge. They never give the ball to Felton. They never give the ball to anybody else but those two guys. Like, I even seen Gerald Wallace sit out for, like, almost half a quarter. Like, I don't know if he went inside the locker room and was like, man, F y'all, I'm not playing. I'm throwing the game. Like, I don't know what it is. But Brandon Roy and LaMarcus Aldridge, they force it all game long.
Now as we get going here in the fourth, let's send it over to Doris Burke for our Sprite Spark.
Well, Kevin, our spark of the game in this one, the stretch by the 76ers. They look like an entirely different team on the defensive end following halftime. When they came out of the locker room with a new level of intensity, that is how they got control and jumped out in front in this one.
Great stuff as always, Doris. Thank you, Clark. That was the game's critical point.
Yeah, I agree with you there. I really think it was. I mean,
all right, starting out on the fourth quarter, I just came in from being subbed out. Once again, they got Brandon Roy forcing the issue. This guy can't do anything, but check out the rebounding, man. I'm telling you, Portland probably got about 15 offensive rebounds. We cannot get a rebound to save our lives. That's the only downfall about NBA 2K12 and your team's AI. They don't do anything right. Like, I just can't understand it. Out of all of that, they got the rebound. And somebody scored, and Babbitt came down to hit another three. It's just unreal. But we're up one. Me and my boy Booker playing hot potato once again. We do that probably about once or twice every game. We play hot potato. Whoever cuts to the basket gets the ball for the bucket. I don't know, man. I don't like to argue with him. I don't like to say anything. But check this play out right here. I profiled. I don't know how far, man. Some of these animations kill me, but you can only do but so much. Now check out Matthews come around and just shoot the jump shot. Nobody in his face. I'm telling you, 2K is designed for you not to win. But I come down on a fast break layup, and Booker is the enforcer. I don't know what just happened. He just bulldozed both of those guys over. He feels how I feel, man. This 2K BS. So me and him are setting up more and more. I'm getting more assists. Man, my assist total is crazy. Like, but I still had to score a lot this game, but it's all good, man. I'm running that patented play once again. I know you guys love seeing this play, man, because anything could happen. Look at that. Could have shot the three-pointer, but nope. Dom City. We going in for the alley-oop once again, man. Booker, oh, man. Booker sets the best screens on that play. Like, that's why I love setting up that play with him, man. Like, I probably only do that play when Booker is in the game. Like, anybody, any other center in the game, I can't trust it, man. Booker sets the nice screens. I come pop out up at top. Then my boy Paul George cut back door every single time. Now check this out. We just playing around right now. He should have got a 5-second call, but it's all good because we out on a break. Brackens, I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry you couldn't catch me. It's all good. But check out them nice LeBron 9s. I'm loving those things. But the game is, you know, completely over. It's nothing that they could really do. I just want to thank you guys for watching. This is IKC signing out. And I'm going to see you guys at game two.
So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. They put on a show tonight, thoroughly controlling each end of the floor.
Hey, what more can you ask?
So game one is in the books for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan. We'll see you for game two as we present our Jordan Player of the Game.
Dom City Music. Dom City Music. Dom City Music. Dom City Music. Dom City, Dom Dom City. 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 City feels, Dom City feels, Dom Dom City feels, Dom City feels, Dom Dom City feels, Dom City feels, Dom Dom City feels. Let's go, let's go. They can't stop Dom City. Let's go, let's go. They can't stop Dom City.
Go up 1-0 with the win tonight, getting things off on the right foot in this series. How do you capitalize on that moving forward to game two?
It's good to get a win in that first game. I know we definitely felt the pressure to get it done and not have to play from behind. When you start any series out with a win, it gives you that much extra confidence moving forward. I think we just need to do everything we can to carry that forward to game two.